Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Today's the day we've been waiting for a year to get to. This is the 34th annual Teddy Bear Parade brought to you by the Soroptimist International Gresham, filmed right here locally on MetroEast Community Media. I'm Greg Matthews with Carol Nielsen Hood. Carol, what a great day.
This is absolutely perfect for our 34th parade, and the weather is just perfect.
And we're going to be bringing you all kinds of information from a lot of people, but we want to just hit our sponsor really quick. Our premier sponsor for the event.
Our premier sponsor is Weston Buick GMC, and we're just so thrilled to have them. This is probably their sixth or seventh year of sponsoring us, and they're the largest pre-owned inventory in the United States, and so we're really pleased to have them as our sponsor again. You know, they do so much for the community. They're always everywhere helping everybody out.
They sure do, and our viewers right now are getting a glimpse of our area's finest. These are the Gresham police officers leading the parade, as they do all the time. Gresham Police Department, we've got the motorcycles out. These motor officers are wonderful, and I think heading down the road on that bicycle, just about out of control, that's Interim Police Chief Robin Sells.
Oh, is that who that
that's
is?
That's who that is right
oh,
now.
Oh, wonderful. Well, you
passing
know, they're
stickers.
Handing out their badges. Is
they're
that
handing
what they're
out
doing?
Stickers. What they're trying to do is get in front of the fire department handing things out, but that's okay. That's all right.
A little bit of rivalry there.
They are wonderful. Nothing but praise. And I'll just say, Officer Sweezy, of course, Officer Rasmussen, I appreciate their work. These guys are school resource officers, so they're out there doing great
doing?
Work. They're kind
Hello.
Of a conduit for the community, doing great work. Officer, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Ride carefully.
Hi, there goes Weston Buick Kia GMC, and this is our very first.
The banner approaching us by the Scouts. Thank you very much. Pack 6, Boy Scouts
Pack 6,
carrying our sponsored banner.
Wow, wonderful.
And I see Tom Slider there as well. That is awesome.
And then we have Tom Slider, who's walking beside it. He always works with the Cub Scouts, and so we're pleased to have them here today.
So say hello.
Smile and wave.
That 54 Chevrolet fire truck, I believe that came from Matthew's Memory Lane.
Oh, did it really?
Yeah, there's Brad Rowe. Brad Rowe celebrating 30 years with Weston GMC. Buick, Kia, Pontiac. Great job, Brad.
It's a great company.
Congratulations. Jan J. Weston, keep up the great work. Josh as well. We appreciate everybody. Primary sponsor, Weston. Of course, they do a great job.
Right.
Weston Buick, GMC Kia. And now we've got Mount Hood Community College coming our way. Also a parade sponsor. How about
this?
Right,
right. And Debbie Durr is going to be riding today in their vehicle. And we're pleased to have her here as our president. This is, about her third year as being president of Mount Hood Community College. It's a great college that we have out here, and they serve about 13,000 students throughout the year.
And you're looking at the big saint right there, but Dr.
Durr. Yeah, that's Bernard. Yeah, hi,
and they're
Debbie.
Also, they support and sponsor the Soroptimist Dream It, Be It program.
That's
helping
exactly
high school
right.
Prepare
exactly.
And reach
Smile.
The next level.
So then next we have our Teddy Bear Parade. We have Powell Valley Assisted Living. And there's Pam in the blonde. She's working. These are her employees, and that's a great place. We go there and meet once a month. And their service is absolutely wonderful.
Awesome.
Their clientele is really happy, and it's just a lovely place to go.
Love the color coordination, too.
Yeah.
And they promote health and happiness of both residents and staff, treating each and every person dignity and respect. Appreciate that work. So important. Thanks for all you do. Powell Valley Assisted Living. And memory care. Well, look who's coming this way next.
Oh, my goodness. Here comes our mayor.
Absolutely.
And his
Mayor
family.
Shane Bemis, his lovely wife, Alex. I think we've got the whole group, right? Yeah, Derek and Luke and Jake looking good. The Bemis family. There we are, Gresham's first family.
And there you got Tom
Mayor
with
Bemis,
them.
Good morning.
Yes.
And Todd Curtin as well.
Tom is well ready with them.
Got all the kids. Oh, we got the Ducks game at 2:30.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Appreciate all they do.
Oh, hi, Marty.
And the mayor has really been able to strike a balance and works hard for this community and also his family. Yeah. But I really appreciate the work he does.
Well, he's been a wonderful mayor.
You've known him a long, long time.
Yeah,
long
we have.
Long before this.
Yeah.
But he's done tremendous work for
right.
City of Gresham.
And then we have Councilor Jerry Hinton. He's in position number one. And he was elected to the council in 2012. And sworn in 2013. He's general manager of Rasher Portland Auto Auction.
Absolutely.
And he has lived in Gresham since 2003. So 2003. So we're very grateful. I like that.
And Councilor Hinton actually contributed through Rasher's some great, they are incredible back seats and front seats at the police and fire department.
Oh, really?
Councilor Hinton, keep up your great work, sir. Appreciate all you do for the city.
Oh, here's Kirk French.
Oh, Councilor Kirk French in this beautiful Kia from who? Weston Kia.
Yep. And he is in council position two. He was elected to a four-year term in November 14.
Absolutely.
And he's sworn into office in January of 2015.
Councilor French, appreciate all the work you do. Great job, sir, and thanks for coming on out again.
And now we have a GMC. We have City Councilor David Woodmark. And David's been on council several different times. And he's retired from the council but was appointed again and in 2015 to fill a vacancy. And now he's running again.
Absolutely.
He does a great job, and he's so concerned about the citizens of Gresham.
Absolutely. And his wife, Cheryl, today,
yep,
with daughter Allison and grandson Mark. And Councilor Woodmark is, I'll say running for re-election. I really stand behind the work he's doing.
Absolutely.
He's strong work, Councilor Woodmark. Way to go, sir.
There's, Councilor Lori
Stegman.
Hi.
Good morning. She has served as city council since 2011. Sworn into office most recently on January 6th of 15. She grew up in Rockwood, chose to locate her farmer's insurance agency in the same neighborhood. Been an insurance agent in the area for more than 20 years.
Yep.
She's joined today by John Sage, her partner and daughter, Rachel Fetters, and friend, Bryn Lerma.
And this is all about automotive. They've provided repair and maintenance needs to Gresham area trucks and car owners since 2000, and they've kept my car on the road going all these years.
They do a lot of work. And so when Steve and that's a Soroptimist Award winner, by the way.
Oh, Desiree there's Zanner. Desiree Zanner.
Hi, Desiree. How are you?
And
good
Angela
to see you. And,
hi.
All
hi,
about
Steve
thank
and
you.
Karen.
And Logan
hi.
Is 11 years old. Logan, I'm guessing first timer to parade. Nice. She is a recipient of your Live a Dream Award.
Also absolutely. That's one of our awards that we give away every year.
And to receive the endowed scholarship.
Yep.
That's
and
awesome.
Here we go to Weston Pontiac. And, well, guess who we have here? Diane McKeel, our Multnomah County Commissioner. She's walking. She's not even riding in a car.
There we
good
are.
Good for you. Good exercise.
Once again, in
good
touch with
you.
Our community, Diane McKeel, accessible, available. There she is. Serving and representing East Multnomah County.
And done a great
issues
job.
Her office focused on veterans, the military, ending human
job.
Trafficking, economic development, and transportation.
And here we have Shirley Craddock. She's also walking.
I'm going to guess they allow them in the car. They just chose to walk, which is awesome.
I think that's great. So she was sworn into office in 2011 as our Metro Councilor, and she was on City Council with me.
Councilor Craddock ran for Metro Council to help increase access to good jobs,
range
of housing choices in the east part of the region. Councilor Craddock, welcome.
So this is sponsored by Pediatric Therapy Services, and Pediatric Therapy Services is an innovative private outpatient physical, occupational, and speech therapy clinic dedicated to improving the well-being of children. It's really very, very nice.
Yep, they improve mobility, strength, coordination, as well as cognition, social-emotional development, sensory processing. They have an aquatic therapy pool in their new building right over here on 3rd and Hood.
Right.
Pediatric Therapy Services.
Look at all the teddy bears. See, that's a wonderful thing about this parade.
There we go.
There's teddy bears in every shape, size, color that you can possibly get, and I love that.
And here comes the band, Gresham Barlow School District. 18 schools, more than 11,500 students. Gresham, Boring, Damascus, and Orient. Known for providing a safe, positive, supporting learning environment for the students. Look at this group.
Wow, that's good.
That's real good.
That was good.
That's Gordon Russell Thunderbirds right there banging on the drums.
That's good. The Gresham Bar.
James Hugh, hey,
there's our superintendent.
Jim Schlachter, great to see you, sir. And Jan Schlachter as well. Good to see you. Thank you for being here.
Love that car.
You know, they've got an issue coming up in November. They're hoping that
they
people
sure
come out and
do,
support.
They sure do, don't they? So
Kelly Creek, they're going to continue to follow Gresham Barlow.
We got 1, 2, 3, 4.
Hogan Cedars, East Orient, East Gresham.
Wow.
Awesome.
Every one of the grade schools, I think, is great.
And, of course, these are the elementary schools, and I believe, you know, about 10 of them. And then they'll be followed probably by the middle school, and I'm guessing the high school will return. And last night was homecoming night for both Gresham and Barlow.
I didn't get to
here
go
there,
to
West
that,
Gresham Elementary,
that.
Powell Valley Elementary, Hollydale, and North Gresham. Where's Miss Kai? She's usually out there.
There.
Hey, look at this. Damascus, Deep Creek. Awesome. Deep Creek, Damascus, Clear Creek Middle School. Dexter McCarty Hornets.
Gee.
The Gordon Russell Thunderbirds. West Orient. The Wolverines are here in force.
Everybody.
Wolverines looking good. Springwater Trail in the house.
My goodness.
Sam Barlow, the Bruins, and the Gresham High Gophers. Look at that.
That's wonderful. Oh.
Let's give everybody a moment to listen to this band.
Right on.
They are going to rock it for us.
you.
That is pure art.
Wow, that was good. So now,
speaking of art, seven brides for seven brothers. Brides. Thursday and Saturday, 10th through the 12th. Go check them out.
Smile.
You guys got some moves.
He sure does, doesn't he?
Wow.
Okay, Shayla Montgomery, she...
National American Miss Shayla Montgomery, crowned Miss Oregon preteen. She competed in November against girls from all the states. Shayla captured the first Oregon national title. She is your 2015-16 National American Miss Preteen National Queen. Shayla volunteers a variety of nonprofits, organizations including Continue to Find Kindness. The organization speaks to girls about ending bullying.
Boy, isn't
congratulations
that
and thank you for being with
that
us, Shayla.
That is wonderful.
You look beautiful today.
So here we have the Phonics Factory. This school started 23 years ago, and the Phonics Factory has participated in the Teddy Bear Parade for over 2 years. They serve children from preschool through 10th grade. Their mission is to prepare children to become self-governing, productive people, to teach them to think, speak, and write with clarity. Hi, smile.
Looking great. So they prepare children to become self-governing, productive,
yep.
To teach them to think, speak, and write. That's great. To learn to honor the values of hard work.
Right.
And do their best to inspire them to greatness. Monica Barham put this together, but the group showed up. Manny, good to see you, sir. Phonics Factory, Mayor Christian Schools, congratulations on a job well done. That's great.
So, you know, for a lot of these children, this is their very first parade.
Absolutely.
So this shows that in Gresham, anybody can be in a parade that's of any age at all, and we're just so thrilled to have them all participate.
And here comes the Center for Family Success, a program of Pathfinders of Oregon. Their purpose is to improve outcomes for children of justice-involved parents by providing programs and family stabilization and the services they need. The Center for Family Success is a nonprofit organization. Well done. Keep up the great work. They work to break the cycle of criminality with cognitive-based programs, support services to help inmates prepare so they can successfully re-enter society. That is strong work, and I wish you the best
right. And
the most in success.
And their leader was Angela Beam and Don Butler.
Absolutely.
Oh, here we go with the Montessori school.
Bill Hay!
Yeah.
Right there he is.
He's going to have 30 to 40 people in his group, and the Montessori School was established in 1970, and they have participated in every single Teddy Bear Parade for 34 years.
Yeah.
The school is a Montessori preschool for children ages 3 to 5. They want to make students have fun at school, believe in learning is an adventure for life.
They're great. You know, and here's a question, fun little fact. What do Larry Page, Sergey Brin, Jeff Bezos, and Jimmy Wales have in common? The founders of Google, Amazon, and Wikipedia spent their early learning years in a Montessori.
Wow, that's...
Here's the cool bus. I love this
that.
Thing. I look forward to seeing it every year at the car
that
show.
That is cool.
And in this parade. That thing is incredible.
I love that size of that.
Oh, it's beautiful. It's well done. And he knows who to call if he wants to get rid of it. Golden Montessori. Nice work.
So coming up, we have the Farmers Market. And it goes from April through September. This is their third year in the Teddy Bear Parade, and the Gresham Saturday Market strives to provide Gresham and East County residents the best produce, flowers, crafts, and more. There's weekly live entertainment from 11 to 3. This family market has voted the best farmers market in 2015 in Gresham. And you know, I've also gone there, and it's wonderful up there because there's no problem with parking.
And here we have the Dana's Dreamers, differently abled, nationally accepted. They advocate for the differently abled community. They're an energetic group of children and young adults who, through cheer, flag and dance,
smile,
performance, bring inclusion to the community at large. That's awesome. Dare to realize that everyone can achieve a meaningful and enriching life while reaching for the stars. Folks, the acronym is DREAMERS. Great job.
Oh, and we have here Brookdale. Chestnut Lane is an assisted living residence for deaf and the deaf and blind seniors from across the country. Continent. It was established in 2003. They are the only deaf and deafblind community west of the Mississippi.
Wow.
Their leader was Ryan Haddon.
That's incredible.
Great.
And plus they have this big, large truck right
here. Wow. Is that
and
what you call a Mac?
Well.
Is that a Mac?
I don't know who put you up there, but you look good.
You do look
beautiful.
Good. There you go.
Looking great
so,
today. The green section. So we're into our green section now.
And our walker is Renee, and she's one of our Soroptimist members. And so we, with every one of these sections, we have a Soroptimist member walking.
That's great.
And so everybody in our club is
And we'll have a lot of animals today. And speaking of animals, also Gresham Animal Hospital. Appreciate all that they're
absolutely.
Doing to help us.
Dr. Chris is something else.
Scribbles Preschool, we've seen them before,
yes,
right?
Yes, we have.
Okay.
So go ahead.
No, go ahead and tell us about Scribbles.
Scribbles Preschool is an educational preschool program for children 3 to 5 years of age. It is hands-on and family-involved. They have participated in the parade for over 8 years. So visit Scribbles School for more information, and their leader today is Jill Russell.
They've got over 75 people, and I think they underestimated. I'm going to guess it's about 100 or so.
Look at all of them. This
Jill
is
Russell,
wonderful.
Nice
Smile.
Job. Looking
Hi,
good.
Hi, smile.
Scribblespreschool.com for more information. Check them out.
Yeah,
and,
look at the
again,
little ones. They're
people.
Darling.
That's not easy to assemble. And look at this, the not exactly Panda Express, but it's a panda for the U.S. World Class Taekwondo. Check them out. Oh, we've got some nunchucks out here. Somebody doing a little display. Kids, don't try this home. Well, don't try
it at my home.
You could break something. Two locations for martial arts training in Gresham by U.S. World Class Taekwondo.
Oh, what? Oh, we're going to have a demonstration right here in front of us.
Oh, he's going to fly and break a board.
Whoa!
Yeah!
Wow!
Wow! That was awesome. That was incredible. Nice job.
That's good.
So students required to volunteer in the community in addition to their martial arts training to achieve black belt status. Volunteer efforts include Nadaka Park annual cleanup, volunteering with the Gresham Area Arts Festival, and my father's house. 29-year-old business, participated in the parade for 7 years. Great job.
Right.
U.S. world-class Taekwondo.
And their leader is Master Sam Leader.
Yes, Master Sam. Congratulations.
Master Sam.
Well done, sir.
Yeah.
So, Ed Eustace, this is Cora's car. This is a Dodge Dart. Grandpa Ed and granddaughter Cora riding in the Dart. Someday the Dart will belong to Cora.
Oh.
Third year in the Teddy Bear Parade. Cora, you have got a beautiful Dodge Dart. Congratulations, but you can't drive quite yet.
No, not yet.
But
maybe.
I look forward to seeing you grow with this parade in the back of that car.
How lucky
great
is
to
she?
See you.
How lucky is she?
That's great.
So the Pirates of Portlandia.
Arr, me mighties.
This jolly band of rascals, scoundrels, villains.
But they are an incredible group. They are the Pirates of Portlandia. All they write is, of course, fiction only, but I'll tell you, what kind of socks do they have on? Argyle. That's right. You heard it here first, folks.
Gresham Grade School. They're established in 1923. They participated in the Teddy Bear Parade for many years. There are over 300 students in this school. This elementary school staff, parents, and community are committed to working together to create an environment for student success. Their leader is Kelsey Boyd, and they have 20 to 40 costumed marchers.
Yeah, costumed marchers. Hey, they look great,
don't
they?
Yeah, they look wonderful.
And they're keeping their distance from pirates, which is keeping you safe.
Wow. And here we go, the Corbett Children's Theater. Have you seen them?
I have. They seek to be a model of excellence in theater. They provide safe family environment for children 4 to 18 years of age to learn different aspects of theater. Their mission is to provide entertaining, professional quality theater performed by children for audiences of all ages.
So,
they educate, challenge, and inspire youth. Keep up the great work. And who's next?
Now, I'm going to let you take this, Greg.
Small
this
World
is a
Learning
bit.
Center, 16 years in the parade. We love Small World. All they do, Teacher Claire up there up front, great. Great to see the families. Hello there, and the White Bear is very special with Miss Carlene. But I miss my daughter, Jessie. She's out there somewhere. Can't quite see her. They touch the lives of future Gresham. They care for children 6 weeks to 12 years. Locally owned and operated. My wife and Suzette Matthews, my lovely wife of 17 years, celebrating our anniversary today.
Happy
They've been voted best daycare preschool learning center for 8 years. I really just want to say we have amazing families, amazing staff, and there's an amazing lady in that Jeep who's running it all. And
she is.
With the help of Carlene Ryan and Cynthia Goldberg and many, many more. Thanks for the work and congratulations, honey, on another great year.
Oh,
and,
look at that.
There we are. Hello there.
Darling, that's really
and
cute.
And the big yellow bear looking good, too.
Yep. I remember when she started that, Greg.
And there's little Sammy Matthews at 11 years old right there. Hi, Sam, looking sharp. All right. And her good friend, Juju.
Yep. Isn't that great?
That's fun.
Oh, so now we're on MetroEast.
Awesome.
They're who filming us today. So I want to thank them because, you know, without them coming here and doing this for us, we wouldn't be hot in the South.
They're incredible. In fact, they empower local government, schools, community groups, nonprofit, and everyday citizens through media. Nonprofits like Soroptimist, MetroEast, Performance Partnerships that provide a platform through which they can educate the community and promote their mission. This is an amazing group. In fact, folks, if you're one of our thousands of viewers at home right now, I can tell you what you're watching is a product of MetroEast Community
Media. That's
exactly
right.
They do incredible work, and they're in the booth, they're in the field, doing great work, MetroEast Community Media.
Well, if you want to know what's going on in Gresham, all you have to do is watch MetroEast.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
They're so good.
Hey, Sam Barlow Theater Department, there you are promoting the nationally award-winning theater department, and invite you to the musical Grease, November 11th through the 19th at Sam Barlow. They are doing Grease at Sam Barlow. And again, this cannot be understated or overstated. They are the high school's nationally award-winning theater department at Sam Barlow, right here in the Gresham Barlow School District. Sam Barlow, how about that?
So now they say that that's a 1958, oh my goodness, Chevrolet Ballet and a 1956 Chevrolet.
Grease Lightning!
Wow. Look at that.
They're even singing as they go.
Yes.
Awesome. Thank you, Jeff Schroeder, for putting that together.
That's great. Eastside Timber Soccer Club.
Absolutely.
This club has been established for 15 years and participated 10 years in the parade. Eastside Timber Soccer Club provides recreational competitive soccer for youth ages 4 to 18. Their primary objective is to provide a comprehensive soccer program while promoting the development of sportsmanship, character, and the joy of soccer. Oh, I love soccer. To their players, parents, coaches, referees, and fans, East Hill provides a positive and fun environment for kids to grow their passion for soccer. And their leader is Rachel Callison, and they got 30
to 40. They look great. And I want to just say a special shout-out to a very dear friend of mine, Amy Prost is out there. Amy, you look great this morning. You're beautiful. Keep up the great work. Good to see you. Oh, here comes Purple. Sponsored by Warren Allen LLP, Attorneys at Law.
Right.
In
the Purple section, and we have Jane Patterson, who's one of our Soroptimists, is their leader in the Purple section walking. So then we have Restore Hope. Restore Hope's mission is to protect children of all ages from child sexual abuse and help survivors heal. They prevent child sexual abuse through education brochures and resource guides, facilitating stewards of children, prevention training, in-person panel discussion, and their website. So, and their leader today was Pam Congdon, and we're so grateful for them for what they do.
Well, very good and well done, and thank you so much. And look at who's in car number two right here.
Well, wait a minute.
This
I
is
thought
incredible.
We were here for Teddy Bear Parade, and there's Santa Claus. What's
there
going on?
There is Santa Claus, and that Santa is very special to me.
Oh,
I love Santa.
Oh.
Santa, it's great to see you this morning. Mrs. Claus, it's wonderful to see you as well. Thank you for restoring hope, Santa. You're always about the kids. We love you, sir. We love you, ma'am. Thank you for your great work.
That's cool.
Santa, oh, my goodness. He is a legend. Everybody loves him. I can give you more information about Santa, but we love you. And and Tom, you're out there, too. We love you. And thank you for all your work. Do a great job. East Coast Diversified. They provide homes and jobs to adults with special needs. They participate in Teddy Bear Parade for 6 years now. Almost 50 years they've been around helping individuals with developmental disabilities live, work, and play in our community. Nice work, Tom Weiss.
There, yeah.
Well
Good
done.
Good job.
And, you know, they do some great work. In fact, as when we had a softball team, we would send our jerseys down, and they would do all
their
jerseys,
all
the numbers and letters and all the stitching. And we want to let people know, too, you're tuning in to the 34th annual Soroptimist International Gresham Teddy Bear Parade, and you're seeing an amazing thing right here, smack dab in the middle of Main Street, Gresham, Oregon, USA.
So right now we have the Inspire Dance Center, and they provide a positive environment to educate in the art of dance. Oh, we got some going right in front of us. They develop the knowledge and skills required to create, perform, and understand artistic movement. The Inspire Dance offers the finest instruction in many dance genres. They have been the proud presenter of the Nutcracker for over 20 years. Their performance for 2016 will be at Mount Hood Community College on December 16th at 7 p.m., December 17th at 2 and 7. And come and join us for a magical holiday tradition for the whole family. I tell you, the Nutcracker is out of this world.
And she is performing just beautifully and in Chuck Taylor Converse shoes, I might add. But I'm so glad she showed up because I was Plan B.
You really?
She's just doing phenomenal work. Inspired Dance Center. It's beautiful. Evening with the Nutcracker. December 16th and 17th. Keep up the great work, young lady. You are awesome.
I'd like to see you do all those movements,
Greg. No, you wouldn't, Carol. It would not be that pretty, I can tell
you
that.
Oh, how pretty. Look at these little girls.
This
how
is amazing.
Darling. How
this is amazing.
Darling.
Hi there.
Hi. Can you smile? Wave for TV?
Beautiful.
Oh, look at their darling.
That will be inspiring. It's the Nutcracker, folks, and you can go see the performance.
Oh, here we go again.
I'm going to guess this young man's not going to carry her for the entire parade route, but I'll bet he could.
Oh, how beautiful.
And again, folks, that's December 16th at 7 p.m. and December 17th at 2 and 7, Mount Hood Community College Theater.
Their leader is Debbie Pierce and Kim Rittmiller.
Nice work. Good work. We're going to get to the Gresham Animal Hospital. Dr. Chris is with us.
Oh, there's Dr. Chris.
I think he's out there, probably one of those 101 Dalmatians. that's where my little bulldog Zoe goes. She goes right to the Gresham Animal Hospital. And they've been providing loving care to
Dr.
pets
Chris.
Since 1944. First hospital in East County. Dr. Chris and his staff serve as animal advocate sponsors for the parade. Additionally, he and his staff have been longtime donors and supporters of this event and the Soroptimist of Gresham. Dr. Chris, thanks for all you do, sir. Not only for Zoe and Chanel, but my entire family and all of our pets.
He's really good with them all.
They are great staff.
Yes. So now we have North Gresham Grade School, and they are
North Stars.
North Stars. North Gresham Grade School is a kindergarten through the fifth grade elementary school with 550 students, and I think they're all here. This diverse group of students is actively engaged in their school and their community. The school expectations are to be safe, be kind, be respectful, and be responsible. Amen. So their leaders are Tracy Klinger, and their principal is Michelle Carter. And they have over 100 people here with wagons, with bikes, trikes, just about anything else you can have. Hi, smile.
It's great to have the North Stars. I remember they used to have a group that did unicycles. They used to do some basketball tricks. But North Gresham North Stars, right up there on 217th, that's a great school. And a lot of great, as you can see, a lot
cute.
Of great families,
they're
great turnout. Strong support, nice work.
Every year comes
Anderson Martial Arts. Dan Anderson, his business have been partnering with parents for 31 years to make Gresham a better community. Each year they've entered the Teddy Bear Parade. They invite you to experience the unique classes in karate, Filipino stick fighting, self-defense, and therapeutic martial arts. Classes for people anywhere from 3 to 90 years of age. If you're 91, they'll let you in with a waiver.
Oh, my.
Yes, we will do that. It's a note from your kids.
I would think so, with my kids. Right. So this is East Orient Elementary School. East Orient is a community of learners working collaboratively to inspire every student to be responsible. The school's vision is to build a thriving community of creative and respectful learners. East Orient School is special because of staff, parents, volunteer work as partners in the education process. And I can tell you my kids went there, and I believe every word I just read. Leader is James Malcolm. And they're also going to be having in this an antique 1948 Mack fire truck. And the driver is John Hill.
That's
a white
awesome.
Fire truck. How cool is that?
That is great. And John Hill is the appropriate one to drive that. Retired Portland firefighter after 30 years.
Yes, he. Oh.
Also, I see the eagle spreading his wings. That's pretty
awesome.
There,
that's cool.
Looking real good out here. And, that is Fire District 10's truck. You can see a closer look at that truck at the Fire Station 76 at 302 in Dodge Park. Great looking East Orient display today. Thank you.
That looks
and,
wonderful.
And, John, happy birthday yesterday, a day late.
Oh, really?
I look at Facebook. You know, Facebook keeps you up
on it. It sure does, doesn't it, on everybody? It does. Hi, good kids. You know, it's very unusual to see a white fire truck, isn't it?
It is, and you know why that's white and not yellow or red?
No.
It's because they painted it that color, Carol.
Oh.
So it just happens, and that is a beautiful dog.
Beautiful dog, isn't it?
And an incredible eagle. Spread your wings and fly, my friend.
So this is Raymond Love Agency, and the Raymond Love American Family Insurance was established in 2013. They are in the business of protecting people's dreams. You should love your agent and love your insurance. I sure do. Raymond Love and his staff want you to feel like family, so you know him, not as an 800 number.
And he's got his kids, his family, his friends, and customers entering the parade today.
Right.
Nice work, Ray, and thanks for your
That's
support.
That's great.
Raymond
Amen.
Love Agency, nice work. American Family Insurance.
Insurance.
Teen Safe Driver Program also, we're going to highlight that. Can't be safe enough these days driving a car.
Amen. So again, today we have Mount Hood Dance Academy, and they provide different styles of dance for ages 3 and up. They're located at Gresham. They offer a wide variety of dance. Oh, they're going to perform for us, the ballet, tap, jazz, lyrical, and hip-hop. Please join them for their winter performance in December at Reynolds High School, and their leader is Brittany Cruz. They're going to do something for us. Oh, look at them.
They're getting down with the bad
stuff. They've
got more moves than U-Haul right now. This is the Mount Hood Dance Academy. And I've got a little bit of sunshine in my pocket now that they came by. That's greater than seeing the kids show up at this event. It's just fun to see them.
Oh, look at their moves. They're darling. With their little teddy bears stuffed in their T-shirts. They're darling.
If I did that, I'd look for a chiropractor. But they did great work.
Well, we do have chiropractors, too.
I know. Oh, here we go. This is Gresham Breakfast Lions Club.
The Breakfast Lions Club.
Oh, yeah, I'm not afraid. You can get in the shot. We serve is the motto of the Lions Club International and also the Gresham Breakfast Lions. Serve Gresham community in countless ways, glasses and hearing aids for those in need, children and adults, needy Christmas families, sponsorship of special youth programs such as flags for first graders, academic scholarships, and Oregon Lions Mobile Health. Tom Slider, you made your way back into another group.
Yeah, he went down and came back. But I have to say that the Breakfast Lions group, as I've said before, they're the ones that help us put out all of our roadblock, everything that we need. They're so helpful for us, and we really do appreciate what they do.
And there
goes
Rick Stubblefield, always involved. And, hey, good morning. Got some
beautiful
flare on the
day.
Vest. You're looking sharp out there.
Amen.
Very incredible.
Good job.
You can actually try out the club if you want to be a guest at one of their meetings. They meet every Thursday morning at
Very
the M&M.
Very early on Thursday mornings.
They do at the M&M, 6:45.
Yep.
Here's Gresham Memorial Chapel making their way.
That's cute.
They're a family-owned and operated business. You can visit the website, GreshamFuneral.com. John Gerbus, a 71 graduate of Reynolds High School. His daughter-in-law, Andrea Gerbus, is the driver. The entire group is family. Thanks, John Gerbus. Great work. Gresham Memorial Chapel.
So now we have OET and
the Oregon Equestrian Trails.
Trails was established in 1907. They have participated in the Teddy Bear Parade for 11 years. And this is a nonprofit organization formed to build and maintain horse camps and trails. And we need that. Oh, look at these little tiny horses.
Oh, they're just
horsing
around.
They're cute. Yeah, they're just horsing around. But aren't they cute?
They're adorable.
Oh, look at how friendly. Oh, look how friendly they are.
That is great. And they've got wings.
Yeah.
Poor little fellas think they can fly. And maybe they can. And the cleanup crew.
Yep.
The most important and thankless job in the world. Nice work.
You have to have that.
Oregon Equestrian Trails, Mount Hood Chapter.
Great work. Next we have the Red Group, and this is Liz Del Plato. Liz just got back from a great European vacation. It was all over Facebook, and I was just so envious of what was going on.
Yes.
So this is Fred Myers, and again, Fred Myers is one of our great sponsors that we have every year.
Yes, they are.
And so the Gresham Fred Meyer store has been part of the Gresham community for many years. Fred Bear and the Fred Meyer volunteers are a big part of the Fred Meyer family. The volunteers donate hundreds of hours each year to nonprofit organizations and children in need. And Fred Myers is very proud to be a part of the Gresham community, as well as we are of them. The Fred Meyer Fund award grants to nonprofits in Oregon, Washington, Alaska, and Idaho with focus areas in youth development, K-12 education grants, hunger reduction, cancer research and awareness, military family support grants, and environment education. Their leader was Eva Reidner and Judy Swift. Oh, and here we have the Gresham Historical Society. I happen to be on that board,
and this antique fire truck is a 28 American LaFrance. It's driven today by Steve Snyder and Dick Dowsett. You might remember Dick Dowsett from back in the day. And a longtime volunteer fireman. They restored the truck panel by panel. The truck's final retirement went to the Box Factory Fire. So we want to say also you'll see it at different car shows and check into the Historical Society. That's who sponsored the truck.
Right.
Go see their show.
Right. Guess who we have here?
Tamale Factory.
Tamale Factory right there. They have wonderful food, too. They're locally owned. And Tamale Factory started in the ICANN project, whose mission is to support first-generation college students. And Antonio is their leader. And this is Carla
Palooza for Oregon. Over the course of 30 years, she worked her way through the Gresham PD. She became the first women police chief. She retired to start serving the community on
and she as used to be your partner here, yeah.
She's been up on the booth, but she's out there today in a campaign effort. She's obviously running for re-election.
Right.
Folks are continuing to do the best for Gresham and finding ways to move Gresham forward. She's here by a strong and happy group of supporters, even with Chris Gorsuch, her neighbor in District 49.
And so this is her. This was her dad's car, and she had it all redone. And it's beautiful.
What, no kidding. What, little El Camino. That's great.
Is that what it is?
And
that's
I see Shirley Vandermost yep. there. That's awesome. Very good.
Sam Barlow. Here we go. Let's listen to the music
Principal
for a minute.
Bruce Schmidt driving the Barlow pickup. There's Bruce right there. Club teams actively support the local community. Key Club and NHS volunteers. Folks, listen to this great band.
Boy, they're all right in time. They got that down. Isn't that great?
Well, and here's a few fun facts about Barlow. Obviously, their cheer and their dance teams are incredible. They've got great kids. They do sponsor clinics. But they also, the dance team, the Brunettes, they brought home the second-place trophy from state last year. The
Good.
Varsity cheer team finished fifth in state, and their symphonic band second late state competition. Pretty good. And the Gresham Rhythmettes, they took first. But that's okay. They took first, and Gresham and Barlow took second. And Barlow, I'm proud of them. Sam Barlow High School is where my kids go to school. We love the Bruins.
Absolutely.
Well done.
Absolutely.
Continue to represent the Brunettes. Keep up the great work.
Yep. Oh, and here we have Cha-Cha the Clown is a community helper bringing joy and fun to the streets of Gresham. She also attends events like school carnivals, preschool shows, and birthday parties. Cha-Cha is an entertainer. She loves teaching children skills of art, mime, juggling, and clowning. She wants her audience to have fun and be creative using imagination. Remember that play and laughter is an important part of life that keeps us healthy. It certainly is. You can find Cha-Cha on Facebook and on her website.
And now speaking of awesome, right awesome day for a parade, the weather broke, the sun is out, and here comes
perfect.
Senator Lori Montes yep. Anderson. She's our state senator for Gresham.
Amen, doing a great
Wood
job.
In Fairview. Good morning. She's active in helping families better their lives. She cares about our schools, government accountability, and keeping us safe. And she's actually a product of the Gresham community. And there she is, State Senator Lori Montes Anderson.
Hi.
Good morning. Good morning.
That looks wonderful.
And she's got Matt behind the wheel. Looking good, Matt.
He's driving. He's not listening.
That's good. Focus on the road.
Yeah, look at this. Arthur Academy. Look at the lion right on the front of the truck. Wow. Arthur Academy is a K through 5th grade free public charter school. They strive to raise strong, smart, and proud members of our community. Gresham Arthur Academy is part of the community Barlow School District. The school has received top ratings since it was founded in 2003. They produce some of the area's top kids. Whoa! Oh, look at.
Yeah.
Wow, I thought they were going to dump all those kids right out there on the street.
I'm assuming he's done that before.
I think so, because they all held on.
I told you before, don't try this at home. Try it at somebody else's
home. Oh, my, there it goes again. Their leader is Shannon Chisholm.
That's great
stuff. That is great stuff. It sure is, isn't it? Oh, wow.
So they're raising the back of that thing, but they're also raising some effort there. Arthur Academy, yep. Nice work. Hey, look at this. Miss U.S. of A. This is Miss U.S. of A. pageant. Raises money, teddy bears, and awareness for the Sheriff's Office, Relay for Life, and domestic violence one crown at a time. Awesome. Here they are, the Miss U.S. of A., the inaugural national newly crowned queens, ready for an exciting year. They'll spend the year making appearances, raising money for cancer, bears, and scholarships. Join us September 16th in Milwaukee, or better yet, come and compete. Ages 2 to 55, Oregon State Miss U.S. of A. .com.
Very pretty. So now we have Hogan Cedars Elementary, and Hogan Cedars is still a passion for learning and fosters responsible and empathetic world citizens. Hogan Cedar Hawks come to school every day ready to learn, be safe, respectful, and responsible citizens in our community. Their leader is Elaine Luckenberg and Sarah Kuiperman.
Yep,
oh,
Miss
look
Luckenbaugh
at that.
Somewhere. It's great
wow.
to see Hogan Cedars. We
there
miss you,
go.
Miss Luckenbaugh. How about those Hawks? Oh, they're excited.
Wow.
Hey, kids, be safe, be respectful, be responsible, and be a Hawk. Keep up the great work, Hogan Cedars Hawks. We love the Hawks.
A 100.
Big part of my family.
Is that right?
The Hogan Cedars Hawks.
That's wonderful.
Absolutely. Rick, good to see you, sir.
Yeah.
Keep up the great work and continue traditions of the Hogan Cedar Hawks. You're looking good today.
They do.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that's where all three of my daughters went from kindergarten through fifth grade.
Great.
Great work. We miss them already. First year gone.
What, you got 11? What are your children, 11?
I don't have 11 kids. No, Carol. I have
three. You have three girls.
They're 11, 12, and 15. And yeah,
wow,
there
you go. Okay.
They're incredibly blessed.
Okay, now we have, and this still is, okay.
This is Jeff Willison, isn't it? Allstate Agency?
Yes.
Awesome. And it's owned and operated. Jeff Willison, Allstate Agency. He's a veteran, and he believes that people are more than a number. Take care of the community they serve, and the owner has 22 years in the Navy and the Oregon National Guard. Thank you for your service, and thanks so much. With 23 years in Marine Corps, Oregon Guard, first year in the Teddy Bear Parade. Nice work.
That's great. Now we have Cub Scout Pack 664. The Cub Scouts develop youth with character, citizenship, and fitness. Scouting helps build the future for children by combining educational activities and lifelong values with fun and adventure. They were established in 1960. Yeah.
And Sally Palmer, nice work putting that together.
Right.
Cupcake and Friends. Cupcake and her animal friends bring smiles, excitement, and comfort to all. Successful show careers, the miniature horses have found a true calling in therapeutic work. They visit assisted living facilities and preschools, have even made appearances at birthday parties. If you see them walking through the community, come say hello. They'd love to see you. Their sweet little mini lives.
They're darling.
Meeting new friends. Janine Holland, nice work putting them together.
That was so cute. Oh, this is the Baha'is of Gresham. And the members of the Baha'i faith are deeply committed to the health and happiness of their community. They do this through activities that promote neighborlessness, respect, celebration of diversity, and community building, especially with young people. The world's newest religion, established in the 19th century, states a commitment to world peace and brotherhood, universal education, and the equality of men and women. They believe in the words of their founder, "We are all leaves of one tree, flowers of one garden." Boy, is that good. Leader is Sarah Eckstein.
And Solutions for Smiles, they're owned, husband and wife owners, Doctors Ravi and Mindy, is it Sanaa?
I believe so. Sanaa.
Very good. They've been serving the Portland surrounding area since 1999. Multiple solutions offered to restore your smile from a male and female perspective. Get them both. They provide each patient with comprehensive oral health and treatment options. Clients' comfort and trust receives their highest priority. Great for you, and thanks for being involved. We really appreciate that so much. And Dr. Ravi, recently elected to be the regional director of the American Academy of General Dentistry, learning his leadership skills and knowledge with others in his profession. That's great work, and congratulations, Dr. Ravi.
Yeah.
Great.
They're one of our sponsors today, and we really appreciate that also.
Dr. Mindy, thank you, and Dr. Ravi, excellent.
So we have Ronald McDonald here, and Ronald McDonald's occupation is the clown mascot for the McDonald fast food chain. He first appeared in commercials in 1963. Willard Scott, I remember him, claims to have originated Ronald. Willard Scott was both Bozo the Clown and NBC's Today Show weatherman. Children all over the world recognize Ronald. And his leader is Heather Coleman. We don't have
that. That's great. And we have the Salt Academy Performing Arts, nonprofit faith-based performing arts company located in downtown Gresham. Juggling Bears, this kid can do it all. They provide dance, drama, voice, and music to children and adults. Don't drop it, no pressure. You're on TV. They love to participate in local community events, just like the Teddy Bear Parade right here in Gresham.
So next we have the Friends of Michael Calgano. He's running to be Gresham's next state representative to fight for stronger schools, safer streets, and better jobs. He is a fourth-generation Oregonian, a small business owner, and a school board member at Mount Hood Community College. He'll be a strong voice fighting for Gresham families in the legislature. Michael lives here in Gresham with his wife, Katie, a local school teacher. Michael and Katie Calgano are expecting their first child, a baby girl, in January.
Oh, congratulations. That's exciting news. And for more information, michaelcalgano.com. And this group is Yes for Student Success. They're a group of parents, educators, and community members who support and promote the passing of this Gresham-Barlow School District bond in November. Vote yes for our kids. And thank you, Stephanie Kraft, putting this together. Vote yes for student success.
Right.
They've got quite a group circulated today.
Boy.
Jeff Reinbelt, right there.
Right there.
Gresham homecoming last night. How'd we do? Did we win, Jeff? Did Gophers win last night? Barlow didn't either.
Oh.
No homecoming victories. What happened? Oh, well. Vote yes for student success. Again, the Gresham Barlow School District Bond. It's a big deal coming up in November. I think,
Amen.
You know, and it's followed by kids.
Look at
How
that.
Do you turn these kids down?
You don't. You don't. Tell you, there, it's going to be quite a, quite with the community center. We have the community center that Gresham wants to build on the ballot. We have the school on the ballot.
Absolutely.
There's a lot of things on the ballot this year that's really important that everybody get out and vote.
And you're looking at the Powell Valley Elementary Parent Teacher Club. They support the students and staff of Powell Valley Elementary and organize several community and school events. The Powell Valley PTC raised over $20,000 each year. All goes back to the school to pay for technology, field trips, and classroom. All I can say is keep up the great work. It's unfortunate there's not funding that does that for you, but you're doing a great job doing it. And tell Ms. Kai, yes, she is the champion, still recognized by me. Their next event is Kids Craft Fair, the first Saturday in December. The event is the community. Everyone in the community is invited. It's a fun event at Powell Valley Elementary. Well done, Powell Valley Panthers. Clackamas
yes.
County Bank, they were established in 1911. It's the oldest community bank in Oregon. Has four locations, Gresham, Sandy, Boring, and Welch's. Bank employees give back by volunteering for organizations that support their local communities. In fact, in 2015, they volunteered over 1,000 hours with the Gresham Breakfast
wow.
Lions Club, Snowcap, Gresham Elks 1805, and 40 other community groups. This is their first year in the Teddy Bear Parade. Welcome, Clackamas County Bank.
Amen.
And Brian York, thanks for putting it together.
Wow, and here we have, I'm not quite sure, is how, Choice? Is
that I believe it's Choice,
Choice Taekwondo. Choice Taekwondo Academy.
Cheese. Chase.
Chase. They're Portland's oldest Taekwondo organization. They teach Taekwondo to all ages. Their focus is to teach their students to become courteous, have self-confidence, learn self-defense, and have a good spirit. They also work with Sun Program at various schools. In addition to teaching self-confidence and self-esteem, they teach bullying busting techniques. Amen. They also offer Gracie techniques, jiu-jitsu for all levels. Start your path to earning your black belt with them today. And their leader is Nelson D. Jose, and we're grateful for them.
And coming into the screen is Joe Swift, State Farm Agency. He's a two-year-old business that has participated in the Teddy Bear Parade each year. Joe Swift, State Farm Agency, helps customers manage from risks of everyday life, recover from their unexpected, and realize their dreams. They strive to be the first and best choice for your insurance and financial services needs. They've got a nice little float
they
and a big
sure
old
do.
Bear.
Hi.
And how about that? Joe Swift, State Farm Agency. And welcome back, Joe Swift. Keep up the great work.
Absolutely. Oh, the next one is Deborah Messenger School of Dance. They used to be above us at the old chamber building.
Yeah.
So I've heard a lot of music and a lot of dance from them. The Deborah Messenger School of Dance was established in 1971. They offer dance lessons for ages, just walking through adults. They teach many styles of dance. They also have a preschool. They teach karate. And they also have music lessons. Classes are still forming now, so it's not too late to join. They are located in the Kelly Square on Burnside. Fall discount specials are running now, so don't miss out. They don't offer just a dance class. They make memories, and that's what they do, an experience that will last for a lifetime. And Tara Marshall is their leader today, and they're just great. I can remember all the children from all the different ages coming up and taking lessons, and it was just wonderful. Look at these girls.
They got a little routine this morning.
They sure do, don't they?
That is great.
How cute.
It just kind of puts a little sunshine in my pocket.
But they're so darling. That's their little t-shirts.
I want to give a big shout out to Justin Timberlake, who has been a part of this parade a couple times today. Pretty excited.
Yes, yes, yes. Look, at now they're doing a little dance here. Look at this.
All I know is the Cricket Wireless folks are happy to be behind this group because they get a little music with their day.
Yeah, you guys get music. That's wonderful.
Cricket's bringing consumers more value with a simple, friendly, reliable, nationwide wireless experience with no annual contract. Power Cricket is our nationwide 4G LTE network covering more than 300 million people. Easy and affordable, unlimited plans are all within, taxes and fees included. No surprises and a great selection of phones that customers love. Cricket Wireless.
I love that car, the way it's painted.
Nice
so
work,
next
Dustin
we have Bell. Prestige Post Acute and Rehab Center. And Prestige Post Acute and Rehab Center is featuring a 1960 Volkswagen Bug as part of their entry. Prestige provides long-term care to seniors in our community as well as short-term rehab. They also provide skilled nursing. Other other of Prestige's locations offer assisted living and retirement community. The core value of Prestige are respect, integrity. Their care is based on a foundation of truth and honor. Commitment, they believe that their service is a calling. It is a privilege and honor to provide senior services. Trust, they know this must be earned. Every day they strive to work in a way that earns trust. And their leader is Evie Merck. That's cute. Oh, look at.
Look at that little. You know what,
cute.
Carol? They are barely hanging on to that Volkswagen today.
That is true.
Wow. That's just too easy. Spencer Lund Agency. Got Farmers Insurance Agent Spencer Lund. Number 14 is what we're looking for.
MBank is also one of our sponsors, and they're a local bank. MBank was established in 1995. It is a full-service community bank focused on the banking needs of businesses and consumers in the metro area. MBank is big enough to have all the products and services you need, but small enough to provide you with the personal service you deserve. MBank's local banking is back. FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Their leader is Andy Klink.
And this is Mobile Pet Grooming, Soapy Dog. So the Soapy Dog Mobile Pet Grooming, local mobile dog grooming service, providing the convenience of front door service for your pet grooming need. Soapy Dog's a brand new mobile pet grooming service coming to the East Side. Member of the International Pet Groomer Association. Reliable and convenient service. Excited to join the Gresham business community as they've been lifetime Gresham residents. All right, welcome Tank Wright.
The Portland Skyliners, the Tall Club.
Nice.
This social and information club for tall people was established in 1955. Women of 5'10 plus or men 6'2 plus can join. Miss Tall Portland, Gadewin Swales is escorted by Mr. Tall Portland, Robert Hicks.
And how tall is Mr. Tall?
Well, I would say he's probably 6'6.
We'll give him 6'5, 6'6?
6'8?
6'8.
Very good.
And Miss Tall is how tall?
Six feet tall.
Wonderful.
They both
Wonderful.
Look good.
Miss
yeah.
Tall Portland, Portland Skyliners Tall Club. That's kind of cool.
That is cool.
Very cool.
With the giraffe and the frog. That's cool, too. I kind of like some of the vehicles that all these organizations are bringing into the parade.
It's fun. And this parade brings everything, Carol. Animals, bands, people, cars, trains, automobiles,
just about
horses,
everything. Yep.
Everything. And the Nova Learning Center. Charter School. They are in the Reynolds School District located in the heart of Rockwood. They're a dynamic community public school that educates all children to be confident learners, exemplary community members by ensuring that they achieve academic, social, and economic success. There they are.
And here we have the Flag Portland East Portland chapter.
Yep.
And they provide education and support and compassion to the LGBTQ community and their families in the East County area. The Portland chapter started over 30 years ago near the beginning of the LGBTQ equity movement. The East County chapter serves Gresham, Troutdale, and the Eastern Metro region. Check out their website by going to Googling PFLAG Portland, and their leader is Larissa Sponsler.
Here comes the Kiwanis chapter, the Kiwanis Club of the Columbia Gorge, Troutdale, and Corbett. Global organization volunteers dedicated to changing the world one child and community at a time. Most activities are local. Members of the Kiwanis Club and students in the Reynolds High School Key Club are wearing teddy bear ears and T-shirts with all the names of the planets in the solar system.
Yeah, look at them. See?
Well, there they are, and we're going to spell
them
out for
you,
folks.
They're all the way down the line. Look at that.
We have Jupiter. That's crazy.
Mars
is in front of us there. There's Saturn.
Yep.
Carol, in the distance, I can barely make out that one. The next planet approaching us, excuse me? you fell into that one. So there you are. And
now we have.
And Carol, Uranus is followed by Neptune, and that's the solar system, folks, with Comet in the middle. And all the
Pluto
way back
is still
Pluto.
A planet.
Folks, we're naming planets, and this is a G show, but I got to tell you, that was funny.
Wow. Yeah, so ServPro. ServPro is a 25-year-old business which provides emergency services and cleanup for homeowners and businesses that have experienced a water loss or fire to their home or office. And their leader is Dennis Misford. And look at that. They are located, I think, on about 215th and Stark. I always go by there, and I always think, gee, I wonder where they're at, cleaning up what they're cleaning up today.
Yep, we see them quite often.
Yep, they're busy people.
ServPro and the big, great, bright green bands. Excuse me.
So then next we have State Farm.
Well, this is Rob Hendrickson. The Hendrickson State Farm Agency is here in Gresham providing financial direction and assistance. Rob's weird agency is an active part of the Gresham community. Those are his words, not mine.
That's what he says.
I know. Their focus is business and education over sales and people over profit.
Wow. Okay, good.
Good for them.
And next we have Lori Stegman, a contingency. She is running for Multnomah County Commissioner. Now, Lori rode by once as a Gresham City Councilor.
She's a city councilor.
Now she's coming back.
She is walking
with her group of John and her daughter Rachel and their supporters.
They made it quick, didn't they? She appears as a councilor, now as a candidate for County Commission, Lori Stegman.
First time she rode, now she has to walk. That's what happens when you become a candidate.
And she's been involved in Soroptimist for
over 15 years. And she's
Absolutely. And
she's done a lot for our community, and we're very grateful for that. So now we have happy hour. Oh, this is that brand new restaurant that's right down the street. It's the newest addition to the historic downtown Gresham neighborhood. Happy hour is an upscale martini bar. Oh, got to go there. Serving comfort food with a twist. Happy Hour will continue to uphold the integrity of historic downtown Gresham. They look forward to being a part of all the wonderful local events. And so, you know, I've heard people that have gone there, and they really, really liked it. So next we're going up with Tammy.
Yep, coming into the screen. Tammy for Senate District 25. Practicing pediatric nurse, Tammy Tussis Arnold. She is actively engaged in the community where she serves as Mountain Hood Community College board member, Fairview City Councilor, and Vice President of the West Columbia Gorge Chamber.
She's a busy person.
To be your next state senator. Top priorities are education, better jobs for East County, and safer communities within Gresham, Troutdale, Fairview, and Wood Village. Absolutely. This is Highland Elementary Parent Teacher Club. They were established in 1995 to support the students and staff of the school. They help ensure the success of every student. School's mission statement is that we believe all children are unique, can learn, and succeed.
And now we have Black Bear Diner. Black Bear is a family-oriented group, and they're down on Burnside, and their diner also donates to Snowcap. So go and visit them when you have an opportunity. Oh, this is Gresham Sanitary Service. They are so good.
Oh, we love the Millers. Absolutely.
They have served Portland and Gresham since 1948. Yep. Their garbage is our bread and butter. Your garbage
Absolutely.
Is. This family-owned business started as a two-man operation and now has grown to 25 employees. They have a fleet of the latest model trucks, GPS communication, and the latest computer-based equipment. So we're very grateful, and their leader is Matt Miller. We're extremely grateful for them.
This is the folks from Gresham Fire Station 71 from Gresham Fire and Emergency Services. This is Engine 71 followed by Truck 71.
Look, and we're grateful to,
absolutely grateful to all of them.
Here come
Gresham firefighters. And again, we're just blessed to have
fire
and police from City of Gresham, the great work they do. They're looking good in there.
Absolutely.
Looking real sharp. Nick Haney, Mark Bancroft, looking good.
And to you for being our fire chief, Greg.
He's driving that thing.
Grateful.
I can't even see him, but we've got some great folks, men and women at Gresham Fire serving the community. What's neat about what they're seeing now, this aerial all steer, all those tires shift and rotate just like that.
Well, I was watching it down there.
That ladder goes 105 feet in the air, and they have some highly skilled operators of that truck. There's Lieutenant Pete Graves right there, and Brett Swenson looking sharp. Patrick McCabry in command of the front driver's seat. Love these guys, these gals that serve our community as firefighters. Really blessed to have them. And there's Battalion Chief Eric Lofgren sitting in there as well, and they look sharp. So thanks very much. But the incredible parade is Gresham Fire goes through, and they come through. As we close this thing out with, obviously, City of Gresham Fire and Emergency Services, the great crew of Station 71.
Absolutely.
Engine 71, Truck 71, Command C7, Chief Lofgren. Job well done. And to the Soroptimist of Gresham, job well done as well.
And to you, Greg.
Thank you so much. We'll be back next year, 35th year, Soroptimist International Gresham Teddy Bear Parade, smack dab in the middle of Gresham, Oregon, Main Street, USA. Thanks for tuning in, folks. Hope you had a great day. Carol,
goodbye,
enjoy.
And thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
We appreciate it. Bye-bye.